Okay, so now let's go back to some of the more interesting tasks regarding the, I don't know, like regarding creating the method for checking some things. Like this was an interview question. I remember this, create a method to check whether a string is a palindrome. A palindrome is something that's read the same from left to right, like ASDSAA, something like this, you know. This is a palindrome, or like JKI8IKJ, something like this. Something that's read the same from the left and from the right. Or even like there can be two eights here because now it's completely mirror image of itself. You know, so we need to create a method which will return true or false whether the string is a palindrome or not. And I remember this when I was working in some company, we were interviewing some guys for positions, and this was the first task for them to do. You know, this just checks whether you know anything, you know, and now we're going to create a method for that. And then we'll do another harder one that you guys with your knowledge, current knowledge, can also, I mean, understand. Okay. So what do we need to create? Well, let's say string input equals ASDSA. And it needs to return true for this one. So I'm gonna say system out print line is palindrome. This is how I like to create my methods because it's like way faster. Okay, so we already have the skeleton for the method. And Java knows that it needs to print out Boolean because it's so bloody smart, because I named it is palindrome. If I did something like palindrome, something like this, and I'm like, create a method, it thinks this returns a void because we didn't assign it to anything. But when I created is palindrome, it immediately knew that that was a Boolean. So that's crazy to me. They have built in so many cool features into this. I didn't even have to write anything. So we have some input and we need to check out whether all the characters like at the front match the ones at the end. Does anybody want to write like the basic idea, like just the more general, the general idea of how we would go about coding this piece of, you know, this piece of code? How would we check whether a string is a palindrome? Does anybody want to like try to give just some? Yeah, we can compare characters. How? Yeah, compare. Yeah, basically something like this. A loop from the word. Yes, that's exactly what we're going to be doing. So let's create a loop going to input.length. And what do we need to do? Well, we need to compare the ith character with the one at the end minus I, something like that, right? That's the idea. So we're comparing the last to the first to the last, the second to the second last, and so on. So let's say char first or left, because it's not always going to be the first, char on the left equals string input dot char at I, and char last or right is gonna be char at what, input dot length minus I, right? And we're gonna say if left is not equal to right, we can immediately say return false. And I want you to be comfortable with this kind of thing because you need to think about this like that. If we're comparing the characters and if at any point we discover any difference, we can terminate the loop immediately. We don't have to loop anymore. We have found that it certainly is not a palindrome, but we cannot do else return true, because the logic is not a reverse. Because if the first and the last are equal, well, we need to keep going. There still might be some that are not. So only if we find a difference, we return immediately. Otherwise, we keep on going. We don't return true at that point, because at that point, we only compared one character. You know, so it's really important to know when you can return and when you have to keep going. I usually like to write my programs like this, like I figure out what condition is terminal, you know, the condition that's going to help us exit the loop immediately. And if that condition happens, I just put return and that we're done there. And at the end of the method, I just return the opposite. You know, what does this mean? Well, if we have gone through the whole loop without ever finding a left character that's different than its right one, I mean, the one on the right that's supposed to match the position of that, then we have never found a discrepancy between the first and the last, second and the second last, which means what? Well, that means we can return true since we didn't find the difference, right? And if we run this, this would crash because, I mean, you'll see now. Let me just show you. Yeah, index out of bounds, range 5. Well, I just want to take this opportunity real quick to debug once more because, I mean, I know where the error is. I wrote it by design or not by mistake. But yeah, you've seen me also miss something and genuinely make a mistake. So I'll just put a breakpoint. Yeah, because it says I want to show to you how easy it is to debug like something like this. It crashed on line 70, like it says here, literally. It crashed on some lines inside of like string class that we certainly didn't write, but regarding our code, it crashed at line 70, right? Basically, it crashed at line 63. That's what it says here. But line 63 is calling of is palindrome, and delving deeper, that's line 70 where it crashed. So now we can put a breakpoint there to check out what's going on. Okay, and now we can see that input.length -1 method will fail. Basically, says that. One more thing that I wanted to show you, which is really cool. When you hold Alt, when you're in debug mode, when you hold Alt key, when you hold Control, everything becomes clickable, but that's nothing to do with debug mode. But when you hold Alt key, that just means you can evaluate pieces of an expression. I can evaluate input.length, that will return 5. I can put my Alt on the minus here, so that will evaluate this whole thing. I can evaluate even a variable. What is input? Well, that's asda, you know. What is input char at I? Well, that's an A letter, you know. You can evaluate parts of things, you know. I just want to see what input.length -1 is. I just evaluate that. It's 5 again, because I, what is I? I is 1, you know. I is 0, sorry. So when I evaluate input char at, you can see, oh, we're trying to get a character at position 5 because input.length minus I is basically 5. And we know that input only has, I mean, basically five characters, but we already have seen that this is location 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. These are the characters of the input. So basically, we cannot ask for something at location 5. We have to have -1 here because it's basically the last character is at 4, not at 5. And this is the fix for our program, you know. I just wanted to take this opportunity to show you debugging once more, because that's like the most important thing that you can learn, because you will, of course, have many errors in the beginning of your career and even later. I mean, I debug probably like 3 times a week, you know, and it's usually somebody else's code, which is even, you know, harder to do. So always try to debug your programs, always put breakpoints, always examine what's going on. Just play around with all these buttons, you know, just learn what each does. You know, this one is evaluate expression. So let me show you once again. If I debug the Alt shortcut that I mentioned, that can be done here. You know, I can click here and I can say, what is going to be input.length? Well, that's 5. Okay, what is going to be input.length minus I? Oh, that's 5 again. You know, you can evaluate all kinds of things to figure out what's gone wrong, you know, by clicking on this little, I don't know what this is, a calculator or something. Okay, a little digression about debugging, really useful. And now if we run this bad boy, I think it's gonna run just fine. Now it says it's true, this is a palindrome. Let's make it not a palindrome. False, let's try to mess with it by saying ASD, DSA, maybe it doesn't work for that. True, it's a palindrome. And one more thing, I think we can go up to the half. What we're doing now is we're comparing A to A, first to last. then second to second last, then third to third last, then fourth to fourth last, you know, then this S to this S. We're basically doing double the comparisons that we need. You know, we don't have to go to the end. We only have to go to the half. And let's see if this broke anything. It true again for this. It's true again for this. And the thing is here, if it's like five letters or seven letters or any odd number, this length will be 5 divided by 2 will be 2. So it'll only compare these two. It'll skip the last, but it's fine because this one, I mean, since it's an odd number of numbers, there can only be one here. Basically, it's just going to compare these ones and these ones, which is fine because this one is always equal to itself, you know. So we didn't break anything by halving this, and we only made our program run twice as fast, you know. There it is possible to reverse a string, but there is no function to reverse a string. Input.reverse or some. I mean, there's not a built-in function to do it. So you would have to manually reverse it, and then, I mean, that's basically more work. Yeah, of course, that's another solution. That's a viable solution. We can do that way, but that's slower. This is much more fast. We're only going up to half the string. And that's what they do on interviews. Like, if you provided a solution to reverse a string, how would you reverse a string? Well, you have to go through the whole string, and then you have to go once more through the whole string to come, or okay, you don't have to literally go through the whole string once again, but you have to compare the strings, which again, in the background, that, I mean, when you do something like input dot equals ignore case, I mean, whatever, ISD, this will in the background do something like, I don't know, this is complex, whatever. They're just, I mean, the thing is, in the background, it must do something like that. It must again go comparing character by character. So what are you doing? You're going once for reversal, then going once more for comparison. So you're going through the string 2 times, and imagine it's a string of like 10 million characters, and we're going through half of the string. So this is 4 times as fast as that, you know. I don't care about this. You can do it any way you want, but at the interviews, they will literally ask something like, oh, can you make it faster? Can you optimize your code a little bit? You know, so that's the thing. This is the best way to do it. You know, there might even be a better one, you know? Yeah, of course, ignore case. Yeah.